Beloved ones, when all is considered, promoting divine love, brotherhood, and freedom is a sacred work entrusted to the few. Initiates understand their inner vows to spirit and utilize the resources of their souls to accomplish the seemingly impossible within each life. The bond between you and the Great White Brotherhood will remain strong so long as you stay focused on your higher divine purpose. I encourage you today to view your life through a more subtle spiritual lens. Though you may have numerous educational diplomas, titles, and outer accolades for your various victorious accomplishments, the ultimate God's success is union with your Creator, beingness within the heart and spirit of the Eternal One. This is the fulfillment of the ancient dream of God for your soul, created in His, her image and likeness. In releasing the first volume of my teachings, I have sought to encourage people of all races and beliefs to go deeper into the innermost realms of being, where one contacts his, her essence, known as the soul. Once an individual awakens to her soulful origins in God, it is simply a matter of focus, discipline, and constancy before that one begins to coalesce around her aura the greater vital light of the presence, which is a part of God's universal presence. To know the living presence of God is to receive a constant impartation of light and all of light's virtues and graces. To feel the pulsation of God's breath and heartbeat within self is to begin to resonate within the harmonics of perfection, the fields of cosmic joy. To then continue to self-discover more and more of God within through prayer and meditation is to enter into the most sacred and supernaturally blessed realms of divine love, where co-creation itself is continuously manifesting. Every ascended master's desire is for you to become fully ensconced within your own solar presence, to feel the afflatus of the Holy Spirit, and to be able to commune with and receive your guidance and inspiration directly from your source. Thus, we encourage both self-mastery and self-realization, self-sacrifice and self-actualization within a higher sphere of reality and a more subtle realm of holiness and equanimity. To know God is to love God within self. To love God is to fully embrace the God light within that created you in the beginning of your unique sentient state of awareness as a sovereign being of light, a son or daughter of love. Lasting freedom comes upon and unto the soul that has surrendered to the responsibility and accountability of the holy initiates of light, those who value life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness for all beings. When you are encouraging and supportive of others' spiritual development and soul growth, I am there helping each of you within the steps involved in the ascension process. When you are committed to curtailing darkness, as well as radiating and expanding divine light around the world, I am there amplifying God desire within you toward this end. And when you utilize the dispensations of the Ascended Masters in conscious works of the Spirit, I am serving you with all that I can offer to complete each endeavor with alacrity, Godspeed, and reverent joy. Blessed ones, together we can accomplish more than we can if we work separately or in isolation. To consolidate our efforts through the nexus of true brother-sisterhood requires a level of maturity, givingness, and nobility that becomes a model for many to follow. Although not all will fully understand all our methods or means of expressing the divine's will, wisdom, and love upon earth, the sensitive will feel the inner excitement and splendor that comes when one so consecrates and dedicates her soul to our holy cause. If you are willing to continue to strive and live in accord with the highest spiritual principles and values that you know are true and real, I will afford you ever-increasing graces and boons to support and encourage you. Now be still and know that I am God light within, and feel now the holy pressure of this energy pulsating through your being and raising your vibration a notch this morning. We'll have silence now for approximately 90 seconds. I am Afra. I have come. I have spoken. All is light. All is love. All is of God below and above. We are one. Thank you. I'd like to just reflect a little bit on the heart stream from Afra today, and give you an opportunity to say whatever you'd like if you have any memory of what he said. I could actually reread parts of it. And he titled this Another Take on Love, Brotherhood, and Freedom. And, of course, that's the subtitle of the book, Afra's New Teachings on Love, Brotherhood, and Freedom. So this is another take on love, brotherhood, and freedom. So I'll read it slowly. Beloved ones, when all is considered, promoting divine love, brotherhood, and freedom is a sacred work entrusted to the few. So one of the key words in that sentence is divine love. Many people may talk about love or brotherhood or even freedom, yet the qualifier, the adjective divine, sets it in a higher sphere of reference. when all is considered, promoting. So how do we promote divine love, brotherhood, and freedom as a sacred work, which has been entrusted to us as part of this view? Initiates understand their inner vows to Spirit, with a capital S, meaning God, and utilize the resources of their souls to accomplish the seemingly impossible within each life. So you may think that this life has been really intense in terms of how fast you've been required to accelerate in consciousness, how much you've done. It may seem like you lived 3 to 5 to 7 lifetimes within one life, and that's compared to most people on earth, you probably have, in terms of how much light you've garnered, how much energy has flowed through your chakras, your aura, and your being, how much you've studied and really assimilated. So initiates, those who initiate spirals of light, understand their inner vows to Spirit, to God, and utilize the resources of their souls to accomplish the seemingly impossible within each life. I think we've been called to do a great work, and so at times seems almost impossible to do what we've been called to do. The bond between you and the Great White Brotherhood will remain strong so long as you stay focused on your higher divine purpose. I think at times we may feel that the bond is weak when we have to kind of descend into dealing with so many mundane things. And so the strong bond between spirit and matter, between God and us, can kind of be compromised if we're too focused on the mundane, if we're too involved in the earthy and not really putting our trust in God, our faith in God, and our focus on the divine. I encourage you today to view your life through a more subtle spiritual lens. Though you may have numerous educational diplomas, titles, and other accolades for your various victorious accomplishments, the ultimate God success is union with your Creator, beingness within the heart and spirit of the Eternal One. So, what does this mean? It means that true God success comes when we are one with God. We can have many successes, accomplishments, human approbations. These really are almost nothing in comparison with the humble, victorious one who has done everything he or she is required to do to reunite with God in the ascension. That's the ultimate diploma, the ultimate accolade and title as a free son or daughter of God ascended in the light. That's the title I desire. An ascended being, ascended one. This is the fulfillment of the ancient dream of God for your soul, created in his, her image and likeness. So when we are ideated in the heart of God, there was this dream or vision of who and what we would be fully self-realized. And God has held this inviolate in his, her heart for eternity. As long as we have been alive, our essence has been created. In releasing the first volume of my teachings, I have sought to encourage people of all races and beliefs to go deeper into the innermost realms of being where one contacts his, her essence, known as the soul. So the title of Afra's book, Living a Soulful Life, that's the real title, Living a Soulful Life, Afra's New Teaching on Love, Brotherhood, and Freedom. So the soul is really important to Afra and our understanding of it, and that teaching is scattered and spread throughout this book. Once an individual awakens to her soulful origins in God, it is simply a matter of focus, discipline, and constancy before that one begins to coalesce around her aura, the greater vital light of the presence, which is a part of God's universal presence. So we have to awaken to our soulful origin in God. First of all, accepting the Creator, and then knowing that we were created by God, that's our origin. Not, we didn't come from apes. We didn't come from dust. We came from light. We are part of the original creation. Let there be light. That's our origin. So once we awaken to that, then we must focus, discipline ourselves, and be constant in order to coalesce around our aura, the greater vital light of the presence, vital light of the presence, the vitality of the presence, which is a part of God's universal presence. So our presence is really, and always has been, a part of God's greater presence, because one times one is one. And we are one in our presence. God is one with us within our presence. We are one within God within our presence. That's where we have the harmony and the peace and the all-abiding love, light, and levity of that state of perfect resonance with the One. To know the living presence of God is to receive a constant impartation of light and all of light's virtues and graces. So we're really locked into God when we know God. We're locked into the living presence of God, and there is a constant impartation. How? Through the crystal cord and the light. It's like a cosmic drinking straw, and we're accessing God's eternal light, virtues, and graces. To feel the pulsation of God's breath and heartbeat within self, with a capital S, within our higher self, is to begin to resonate with the harmonics of perfection, the fields of cosmic joy. So how do we feel this pulsation? I mentioned this Monday, I believe. Maybe it was yesterday's heart stream. Was there a heart stream yesterday? I think there was.
Through LA, yeah.
And it was about feeling the inner heat, feeling the inner heat, right? We had to feel the heat. If we don't have the desire to know God and to feel God's presence, we have to stop what we're doing and get back to that state where we can actually feel God within us. To feel the pulsation of God's breath and heartbeat within self is to begin to resonate with the harmonics of perfection, the fields of cosmic joy. So what are these harmonics of perfection? The sciences of the spirit, the solar sciences that we've been privileged to now begin to understand, that we learn about in Meru University and all the classes we've had. To then continue to self-discover, and this is a capital S, so it's discover our self, our true self, more and more of God. To then continue to self-discover more and more of God within, through prayer and meditation, is to enter into the most sacred and supernaturally blessed realms of divine love, where co-creation itself is continuously manifesting. So we are constantly self-discovering more and more of God within. Every day is a metamorphosis. Every day is an awakening. Every day is a peeling away of one of the skins, the onion skins of our lesser self, to embrace the pearl within us, the God light within. We do this through prayer and meditation, and we enter into the most sacred and supernaturally blessed realms of divine love, where co-creation is continuously manifesting. So the creation didn't stop after 7 days, 6 days. It's ongoing, but it's a co-creation. We're part of the process. We are involved. Every ascended master's desire is for you to become fully ensconced within your own solar presence, to feel the afflatus of the Holy Spirit, and to be able to commune with and receive your guidance and inspiration directly from your source, with a capital S. The masters are only there as a kind of a stopgap, temporary tutor, guide, guardian, until we can learn how to do this ourselves. Till we grow up, we become adults, spiritual adults. Thus, we encourage both self-mastery, with a small s, in other words, master of the human, and self-realization with a capital S. Self-sacrifice and self with a capital S actualization within a higher sphere of reality and a more subtle realm of holiness and equanimity. So we have our feet firmly planted on the earth, and yet, being practical, we also are engaged in divine work of the Spirit as we use our chakras, our higher chakras, to invoke the light, receive the light, commune with God, know our source, utilize all the creative gifts and talents that have been vouchsafed to us. This is how we are self-realized and self-actualized. We're realized, though, in the highest sense, in this higher sphere of reality. We draw that reality to the earth, earthy, when we are practical and engage in work of the Spirit while incarnate on earth. We don't just try to avoid the initiations of having to earn a living and do work. We actually love to do that because we see it as a means of becoming. Self-mastery in the physical translates to a greater self-actualization in the spiritual. And those with the greatest ability to anchor light in the flesh also point counterpoint as above, so below, draw that self-mastery into the spiritual realms when they understand from whence the light comes, from whence comes their energy, their very life essence, God. If they do everything with great mastery in the physical, but they don't give deference to God, they're missing something. And eventually they will come to understand that God is the all in all, that we do everything to glorify God and magnify the Lord. We don't do things to glorify the human or the human ego. If we do, it's all going to be falling apart someday. To know God is to love God within self, with a capital S. To love God is to fully embrace the God light within that created you in the beginning of your unique sentient state of awareness as a sovereign being of light, a son or daughter of love. So we each have an envelope of our own unique individualization of the God flame within our own personal auric field that we are meant to develop. We are a seed and we are meant to be planted in the universe to grow into a full-blown son of God and, in a sense, a God being. Not that we can do this without God, we can only do it with God. Lasting freedom comes upon and unto the soul that has surrendered to the responsibility and accountability of the holy initiates of light. We heard about this accountability and responsibility in a recent heart stream. It was the key part of El Morya's recent heart stream. And these holy initiates of light are those who value life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness of all beings. In other words, they're invested in the collective, the egregore, the universal Great White Brotherhood, not just an individual aspect of it through our own unique being, but we work for the whole. We work as a unique individual on behalf of all beings because we are one and we are part of this creation, part of this world. We're all in this together. We may as well take that responsibility and accountability for ourselves and all life. When you are encouraging and supportive of others' spiritual development and soul growth, I am there helping each of you within the steps involved in the ascension process. And I'll be speaking about the ascension process on the ascension panel in San Mateo in late April and at a workshop at the East West Bookshop near San Mateo when I go there. When you are committed to curtailing darkness as well as radiating and expanding divine light around the world, so we both curtail darkness and we expand light. I am there amplifying God desire within you toward this end. So we have to have that commitment. How do we have the commitment? We tell God, I will do this work. I will show up. I will pray. I will decree. I will meditate. I will be engaged. I will come to conferences or events to support the work of the Great White Brotherhood with others of my heart friends, others of like mind, heart, and spirit, because I know that the collective work is more powerful than my own individual work. And when you utilize the dispensations of the Ascended Masters in conscious works of the Spirit, I am serving you with all that I can offer to complete each endeavor with alacrity, Godspeed, and reverent joy. I love the reverent joy. So joy can be reverent. It doesn't have to be raucous, right? It doesn't have to be irreverent. It can be reverent. We can have happiness, yet it's a reverent happiness. It's not like what you see in late night comedy with these guys that just try to put down everybody. You know, late night comedy. This is the true happiness of the spiritually oriented ones who receive their inner approbation and happiness because they know that the work they're doing has value. It has eternal value, not temporal value. Blessed ones, together we can accomplish more than we can if we work separately or in isolation. There are some that can do this in the Himalayas, and maybe they do it in a very powerful way. However, Afra is telling us we can accomplish more. And he's saying the masters in us, not just him alone, but all of the masters. Together, we can accomplish more than we can if we work separately or in isolation. To consolidate our efforts through the nexus of true brother-sisterhood requires a level of maturity, givingness, and nobility that becomes a model for many to follow. So there's a lot of immaturity right now going around on the planet, especially young people that really haven't lived long enough to know what life is really about. And they have these ideals, and they see the evils in the world, and they want to change them overnight. They want there to be just instantaneous, you know, this or that, without going through the process of the work and the striving and the effort. And it's good to have high ideals. It's good to be one who envisions a new planet that's full of light and levity and understanding and brother-sisterhood. Yet we can't mandate anything or force something on others without there being a reaction and often the invocation of darkness in that process. And this is what tyranny ends up accomplishing, ultimately nothing but pain, sorrow, and a diversion away from the divine. So those who try to force their will, their vision on others are not part of the resolution of the conflict on the earth. We do it through love, we do it through understanding, we do it through being a model of maturity, givingness, and nobility. And I think the master put the word nobility in there in the highest sense of the term, that we are noble in how we act. We are reverent. We are thoughtful. We are gracious. We are kind. We are considerate. With social media now and all that's transpiring, we've lost our mores. We've lost our moorings in reality. Not we, but many. And so we have to call it forth again and really call a spade at times and say, listen, calm down, go through the process of self-realization through self-mastery, and then you can change the system from within in a wonderful way. It's very, very, very infrequent that you have to come to arms to deal with tyranny, and that did happen with the founding of this nation. And it may have to happen again in some way if our system becomes too tyrannical. However, the higher road of the initiates is to pray, to meditate, and to draw forth so much power and divine understanding and light that we change it with the dynamics of heaven and the spiritual resources of the ascended hosts. Although not all will fully understand all our methods or means of expressing the divine's will, wisdom, and love upon earth, the sensitive will feel the inner excitement and splendor that comes when one so consecrates and dedicates her soul to our holy cause. In that dedication and that consecration, there is a release of divine energy, and it is a blessing upon you when you consecrate and dedicate your life, your energy to the divine path. There is an instantaneous blessing that comes to you from heaven to support you in that work. It is a universal law. When you give your all to God, God gives his, her all to you. And you have then the wherewithal, the alchemical edge, to then move forward on the path and invoke God's will, wisdom, and love into action upon this planet. So he says again, although not all will fully understand all our methods or means of expressing the divine's will, wisdom, and love upon earth. And I think of, you know, other Christians. We had a guy come almost into our store yesterday. I was with, you know, talking to Nancy, and this guy, we heard a noise, and this guy came down the hallway, and he was, this is not what I know with Jesus, and this is not, I don't understand this, you know. It was kind of crazy. He wasn't ready for our methods, right? He's caught in his own understanding of Jesus, and he can make progress. I'm not saying he's a bad person, but, you know, you can't condemn others in the process of loving Jesus and get to heaven. You can't condemn other people and their religious affiliations. That's not the way of Jesus. He didn't go around condemning Buddhists or Hindus when he went to India. He didn't condemn others, although he did call to task those who were caught in orthodoxy in the Jewish tradition and in other traditions. If you are willing to continue to strive and live in accord with the highest spiritual principles and values that you know are true and real, I will afford you ever-increasing graces and boons to support and encourage you. Back to first principles and values. Now be still and know that I am God light within. And feel now the holy pressure of this energy pulsating through your being and raising your vibration a notch this morning. So part of the purpose of this heart stream was to help us raise our vibration. We meditated for 90 seconds in silence. And then in closing, he said, I am Afra. I have come. I have spoken. All is light. All is love. All is of God, below and above. We are one. Thank you. When we may decide to reread portions of Living a Soulful Life, I think that we can see the stream of Afra's consciousness and his desire for us to be free, to live in brother sisterhood, and to be loving. And that he's pulling out all the stops to help us to reach that state of ascended master consciousness in this lifetime, to win our eternal freedom so that we can do greater work from the heavenly realms. Some of us may be called back again, either by our choice, even if we've qualified for the ascension, or because we may still have a little karma to balance before we qualify. In either case, it's a good thing because the earth requires the light, right? The earth requires all of us. So thank you, beloved master. I hope by me expounding a little bit on the heart stream, I hope that you got more out of it the second time I did. And I thank beloved Afra.